All right, 8477. You calling in for a session?
Yeah, that's me. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And what's your name and what state or country you calling from?
My name is James Mims. I'm calling from Memphis, Tennessee.
You come from Tennessee. Okay, James, how you find out about me?
On the internet, YouTube.
So what you doing a search on help or a particular subject, and you came across my program?
I was just kind of going through it, and I just got through listening to you. Just as a matter of fact, on the YouTube and on the internet. So I called the other number. It said that you're no longer on that number. So I'm just not calling this. This is my first time calling in. So
yeah. When I first started doing live call-in deliverance session, I did it on TalkShoe. So probably on YouTube, probably the first 60 or 70 session, it have that old contact number. So, but rest of the new session, it has the new number. Yeah. So, James, what is it that you want the Lord to do in your life?
I'm demon possessed, ma'am. There's a demon in me. My wife, I believe there's some in her too. We've just been going through so much. Do you want me to tell you from the beginning or kind of
not necessary. All I just want is for you to tell me what you are going through, not you and your wife. You know, I get to that later.
Okay.
Share with me what you have been experiencing, what you're going through, and what you expecting the Lord to do for you.
Okay, I'm expecting the Lord to deliver me from all this medication. They diagnosed me bipolar back in 98 when all of this happened, when sheriffs and witches in sheriff uniform worked witchcraft on me, and they summoned demons in me. They unlawfully had me arrested. This is when I was living in Georgia. And basically, I was pursuing an R&B singing career, and the Lord told me to sing for Him. He told me I was on my way to hell if I didn't. He told me I was on my way to hell, that the devil was trying to kill me, and He wanted me to sing for Him. And after He showed me that vision. After the Lord showed me that vision that I was on my way to hell, I told Him I'd give up everything. You know, I wrote Him a poem, I read it to Him, and I've been going through ever since, you know.
Mm-hmm.
They diagnosed me bipolar when my mom and everyone, they didn't understand. They didn't understand. You know, I would tell them that I was seeing demons, and demons were in me. When they had me incarcerated, they threw me in this jail, and that's where they started performing the witchcraft. Ma'am.
So they just made it worse.
Ma'am. Yes, I started. Only thing I could do was sing out to God. You know, my mom didn't know who I was. My brothers, my family didn't know who I was. My friends, they had me in some little country town. You know, that's where they took me. It seemed like Satan had a stronghold over this whole community. It seemed as though I was praising God for hours or days, just singing out to Him, just worshiping and praising when I was incarcerated, because I've read the Bible where it says where Paul and Silas cast out the demon in the little girl. I think they were trying to use me in that way, you know, that Illuminati and all that stuff. That stuff is real, and this was back in 98. And so anyway, I heard what one of them said. I got kind of sleepy. I laid down on the floor and I tried to get some sleep. And I heard one of the officers say, "Is he on the floor yet?" And when he said that, I felt something coming in my side. And I looked at my stomach. It looked like it was a snake or something in my stomach. It looked like I was praying, but it was moving. My stomach was moving. Mm-hmm. And all I could do, Evangelist King, was just praise God. I knew I had been demon-possessed. I knew it. I was looking at this mirror at a glass door, like a glass opening in the door. If you would have saw me, you would have thought I had on some type of Halloween mask. It formed in my face as I was trying to sing after God. It didn't want me to sing. And I started spitting out white foam and all that. And I told them to let me out, so they finally let me out. And they strapped me to the chair. Now, they were no longer talking to me. They were talking to the demon that they had summoned in me. They were talking to the demon. They said, "What's your name?" And this demon said, "Yakub," in a deep voice. And they said, "Who are we?" And this demon said, "You are white devils. You're white devils." And they were so happy, you know. They were like, we're white devils. We're white devils. They were happy. And in the Nation of Islam, you know, Farrakhan and all those guys, they think that Yaqub was actually a black man who created the white race to get back at the black man, because black men had killed Yaqub's family. That's what that's what the Nation of Islam believes. And so my name used to be Saladin Latif Majid. That's what I was born with. I was actually born into Islam.
Yeah.
And just last year, yes, ma'am. And just, that's the name my dad gave me, but my mom gave me the name James Edward Mims. My mom told me that when she was pregnant with me, I actually died in her stomach. They had to call a code blue, I think. And then the umbilical cord got wrapped around my throat, and I died. And she said she told my dad to name me James Edward Mims. But when she came to, she saw on the birth certificate that my name was Saladin Latif Majid. My dad, who's dead now, he had great expectations for me in the Muslim community. You know, I still remember myself as a little boy, saying Allah walk by, you know, praise Allah and all of that. And Ms. King, just last year, as I was in deep study in my Bible, I heard the Lord told me that he couldn't use me like he wanted to use me because of the name. And so I said, "Lord, what do you want me to do? You know, change the name to what?" And he said, "Change the name to the name I gave your mom, James Edward Mims." So me and my wife now, we actually got my name changed. We went to the court. We went through so much to get my name changed to James Edward Mims. And, you know, back in 98, I got tattoos on my arm, and I got the name Saladin on my stomach.
James, on your stomach, you got this name on your stomach.
Yes, ma'am. And I got a court jester, looks like a demon on my chest, because you know that's what the industry liked back then. They loved the image, and all my life I wanted to sing R&B. I wanted to be the biggest R&B singer that ever lived. Yeah, I wanted to be bigger than Michael Jackson and all those guys. But the Lord showed me I was going to hell. He showed me to give it up for Him, give my career up for Him. He told me to sing gospel. And my mom told me to sing gospel even on the day that I was leaving home back in 97 to move to Georgia. And I told her, I said, "I'll take care of the family. You know, I'm going to buy you a mansion, a car, I'll buy you anything. You know, I just got to go sing my R&B music." And that's all I ever done, you know. And so since 98 until now, I've been going through, you know, 18 double hockey stick on earth. I've been going through hell on earth, Miss King.
I know you have.
And
now,
when I was,
now, James, share with me, how do you come to give your life to Jesus?
Oh, wow. In the jail cell, you know.
In the jail cell.
Back in 98 in that jail cell, I said, this is the last thing I said before they let me out. I said, Lord, I know I never tried to get to know you or your son Jesus, but if I die in this jail cell, Lord, please accept me into your kingdom. Please accept me into heaven, because I was so scared. No one knew where I was.
Mm-hmm.
No one knew where I was. And my mom, who has a beautiful gift of prophecy, but, you know, she's not walking as strongly with the Lord as she should. The Lord led her to where I was. I've been in so many mental institutions, so many. I've never been bipolar in all my life. Now I'm on all sorts of medications, house dogs, Apexa, Depakote, so much stuff, and I can't even work like I used to. I'm a registered barber. You know, I can't cut like I used to because anxiety takes over this demon and I get the shaking. I can't do what I used to. I just want this thing out of me, you know.
Yeah, so since now how old were you in 98?
In 98, oh God, let's see. I was probably about 23, 24, I'm 42 now. I just turned 42 March 8th.
Okay.
So
okay.
I had to be about 23, 24.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what you said, when you was in that jail cell, the officers in that jail cell was satanic worshipers, and they took you out and carried you to a place where they perform occult practices on you.
Well, when I was in the jail cell, you know, I heard one of them say, "Is he laying down? Is he on the floor yet?" And that's when I felt something tingling coming up my side and coming into my stomach. My stomach began to go up and down like I had a snake or something in my stomach. And I started praising, you know, and this demon formed in my face. Like I said, if you would have saw me, you would have thought I had on a Halloween mask. And so I banged on the door. I said, "Let me out, let me out." And they came and let me out, and they sat me in this chair. They strapped my arms and they strapped my feet. And that's when they asked the demon, what's his name? And this demon said, "Yakub." I still remember. I remember just like it happened yesterday because it was so vivid. And they were like, "Well, who are we? You know, this demon said, "You're white devils." You know, I'm not prejudiced in any way. I love everybody, but this is what this demon said. And they were happy. You know, they were witches and sheriffs. Yes, ma'am. They were witches in sheriff's uniform. I'm sorry.
So, James, was that after that, when they put you on that medication? After these things has happened, was that when they put you on that medication?
Yes, ma'am. When my mom finally found me, they had to have me sedated. They kept shooting me up, but even that wouldn't take. You know, when they had you sedated, you're supposed to be out. The demon did not want me to rest. They kept shooting me, you know, in my vein. They had to have me sedated.
Right. So from that day to this day, you still been on that medication?
Different medication, different, they change it up all the time.
Okay.
Yes,
all
ma'am.
Right. Well, after your deliverance, James, you no longer, you really don't need that medication now, but you no longer should take that medication, okay, because you didn't need it. Okay, go ahead.
Can I say something?
Yeah.
You know, like back in the day, I would always hear voice. It said, you know, throw that medicine away, you don't need it. And when I threw it away, I would always end up back in the hospital. I would always go through, my mind would race. and I would see myself walking the streets trying to pray for everybody. I could never get rest. It would be like I would go into anxiety fits. I would be so nervous I could never sleep. I would stay up all night and read my Bible. And I don't know if that was God or not, but every time this voice said, throw your medication away, you don't need it, I would flush it. I would flush my medication.
The reason why those things happened, James, is because those spirits were still in you. That's the reason why it still happened, because those demon spirits were still in you. See, it was because those demon spirits in you that manifested in the people thought it was you, and they thought maybe if they give you that medication, it would help you. But no, every time you take that medication, you feed those demons. You really actually feed those demons in you, and you strengthen those demons, because it's because of those demons why you are on that medication. You never needed that medication, and those. And please, as my dear brother said, all those who are white, don't get offended. The reason why the devil called them white devils is because probably they was white and they was devils. Right. Like a black person, they call them a black devil. You know, if you're Indian, they call you Indian devil, you see. So it was because of those demons in you that had manifested. And the people around you said you needed that medication. And those white devils knew that if you took that medication, then you would get worse. Because what it does, it makes you passive. It makes you dependent on it. And it fools you in thinking that you need it. When actually, again, whenever you take it, you are strengthening them and weakening yourself. Because you never needed it. In the very beginning, you never needed it. It's those demons in you that wants it, that is calling for it. And after the Lord set you totally free, they will be out of you. So therefore, since they will be out of you, you don't need to take it anymore. You understand?
Okay.
Because if you continue to take it, then you're not trusting God, and that opens the door for these devils to come back into you. Because you asking them to. The Lord said every time you, after your deliverance, if you go back and take it, you are literally, it's asking those devils to come back into you, because you enjoy taking that medication, you see, and that medication, that property. Now, I want you to clearly see, you never needed that. You never needed it, because it wasn't you that was acting up doing those things. It was the demons in you. But because those white people full of the devil, they also knew you didn't need it, but they wanted to make sure that the demons in you always had a home. So that's why they prescribed to you that medication. Because again, you never needed it. Okay? So again, God gonna set you totally free, because when you gave your life to Jesus Christ, no one ever have taken you through a deliverance in which they trust God's word and confronted these spirits and commanded them to come out of God's house, because you belongs to God. You belongs to God.
That's right.
Okay, so after your deliverance, then I'm going to share with you about your wife, because your wife needs deliverance too. You know, you can talk with her. You can share with her what God have done for you. And you can let her know about me. And whenever she's ready, she can call. But you have to make sure after your deliverance that you keep your heart and mind stayed on God. And whenever, now you're going to see, because of what you have been going through all the years, you're going to actually see the devil rise up in your wife. Remember, it's not your wife. It's a devil.
Okay.
Your wife is not your enemy. It's the devil. Right, just like you experienced. People thought it was you, but you knew it was devils in you, you see. Well, it's not your wife, it's the devil. So what you do, you trust God, and you don't give in to that devil, and that he's going to have your wife. No, you continue to trust God for your wife. Deliverance.
Okay.
For your wife's deliverance.
Okay?
Now, do you two have any children?
No, ma'am. We don't have any.
Okay, so that, so the
We
devil,
want some, but we don't have any.
yeah, the devil had prevented you two from having children, okay? Because so the spirits in you are saying that you belongs to it, and the spirit in her is saying she belongs to it. So it had prevented you two from having children. But the main thing is, after your deliverance, Jay, you're going to have to keep your mind and heart focused on God. And don't forget that whenever the devil flirt in your wife, that is not your wife. That is the devil.
Okay.
And you got to be adamant
okay.
that the devil is not having your wife. So you trust God.
That's right.
Pray. You pray. You pray. Whenever the devil flare up in her, you pray. And then you have the authority to silence it. You say, in the name of Jesus,
okay.
shut up, devil. Shut up.
Okay.
But when you say this, I don't want you to say it out loud so your wife can hear it. Because the enemy will tell her, you see how he's calling you a devil? So what you do, you smile at your wife. You go in the bedroom or the bathroom where your wife can't see you. And then you say, in the name of Jesus, devil, shut up in Jesus' name. That way your wife cannot
okay.
see you. And the devil cannot false accuse you in her ears that you're talking to her. Because the devil knows that you'll be talking to it. Okay, so this is going to be a
okay.
battle for you. It's going to be a battle for you, and you're going to have to continue to believe that you are set free. Now, the devil's going to try to come back, and they're going to try to convince you that you need to get back on that medication, and they're even going to try to get into your feelings to make you feel like you need that medication. James, that would not be you. That is that devil trying
okay.
to get back into you. You need to cry out to Jesus. Praise your holy name, Lord. Thank you. For you have saved me, you have healed me, you have delivered me, and you just sing praises to the Lord. Just if you have to say it loud, out loud, you say it out loud. You constantly dwell on the Lord, remind the Lord of his word. And then as you do that, that spirit that is whispering to you that you need to get that medication, it will back off from you. Now, it's going to be a battle, okay? But remember, greater, 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 greater is the Holy Spirit who's in and with you than any devil that you saw in 1998. You hear me? Greater
okay.
is the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And you have to continue to receive and believe that, because again, it's going to be a big battle. But Jesus Christ and his angels, you have angels. Now, Lord said what you who you could not see and did not see in that jail cell was angels who was around you. Because if those angels were not around you, James, those white devils would have killed you. And then they would have said he killed himself in jail. They would have
yeah.
done something to make it look like that you killed yourself. But the Lord did not allow the devil to do that. The angels of God was with you then. They are with you now. Understand? So I'm gonna pray for you, and then I'm gonna speak a disconnection. And those of you who still on this line, and God has ministered deliverance to you, I need you also to join. I want you to stop listening, and I need you to join your faith to my faith, and so that we all can come against those strongholds that is keeping James bound. Do you understand? Because 7803 and 5610, you're still on the line, and that is what I want you to do. No more listening. I want you to join in this battle. Our faith come together for our dear brother, total deliverance. See, there's a reason God allowed you two to stay on this phone line, because he wants you to intercede with me for this dear brother, for his total deliverance, for his total freedom, in Jesus' name. So I'm going to pray, and I'm going to speak a disconnection. So, Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you, Father. For, Father, you are greater. There's no one who can go above you, around you, or under you, Father. I thank you, Father, for your loving grace and your loving mercy and compassion that you have shown toward my brother James and toward all of Father. For you are a gracious and loving God. For Father, it's James' time now to go forth in the power of your might, Father. Because every plan, every purpose, every idea that you have ordained to take place in his life is in your own glory to your Son Jesus Christ, it shall come to pass, Father. Father, I thank you and I ask you to give him more wisdom and revelation and letting him see who he only is in your son, Jesus, and also who Jesus is in him, Father. Father, I thank you for covering him with the precious blood of your son, Jesus Christ. I thank you for keeping him, Father, for such a time. For Father, I thank you that his testimony should bring many out of the kingdom of darkness to the marvelous light, Father. Father, we praise you and give you all the glory, Father. Father, I thank you for cleansing your house for true worship, Father, so that James can worship you truthfully and he can worship you spiritually, Father. Father, I thank you that everything that the enemy have done to this young man, you have turned that situation around, Father. You have undone every work, every deed that the enemy have done to this young man. You have undone it by the blood of Jesus. But the blood of Jesus has forgiven him and his ancestors. And I thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. So right now, in the name of Jesus, I command every spirit, I don't have to call you by name, you are not of the Holy Spirit, I command you to pack your load, spirit wife, I command you, witchcraft, pack your load in Jesus' name and get out of God's house. You come out of his mind, you come out of his will, you come out of his emotion, and you come out of his body in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire, set ablaze, such a destroy, such a destroy, Holy Ghost, such a destroy all manner of darkness that's working in hiding darkness in his mind. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn in his mind. Burn every spirit in his mind that has exalted itself against the knowledge of God. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in Jesus' name, burn all evil images that have been embedded and planted in his mind. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn in Jesus' name. Search and destroy, Holy Spirit. Search and destroy all manner of darkness that's lurking and hiding in his emotions. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, burn all manner of spirit that has excited itself against the knowledge of God in his emotions. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Burn every spirit that's not of you. Search and destroy all manner of darkness that's lurking and hiding dormantly in his will. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in Jesus' name. Search and destroy all manner of spirit that has exalted itself against the knowledge of God in his will. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, burn, burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, continue. Search and destroy all manner of darkness that's lurking hiding dormantly in his body. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn all manner of spirits in his body that have exalted itself against the knowledge of God. Burn, 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 Holy Spirit. Search and destroy. Burn in his mouth. Burn in his mouth. Burn on his skin. Burn down his throat. Burn in his ear. Burn in his ear. Burn in his eye. Burn all manner of darkness and wrecking and hiding in his eye that looks through his eye. Burn, burn, burn in Jesus' name. Burn down his throat. Burn in his belly. Burn all manner of darkness that's lurking and hiding dormant in his belly. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in his belly. Burn all manner of snakes and eggs in his belly. All manner of spirits that's in shape of animals and insects and sea creatures. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in his belly. Burn, 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 burn in his private area. Burn, burn in his private area. Burn, burn, Holy Spirit. Search and destroy. Burn, burn all manner of marks that was placed in and on his body. Burn those illegal marks. Burn those illegal marks. Burn, set ablaze. set ablaze those images. Set ablaze those images, Holy Spirit. Burn those images. Burn those images. Burn every tattoo that is still living on his body. Burn! 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 Set it ablaze. Set it ablaze, Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. Burn up every mark, every illegal piercing that is on and in his body. Burn! Burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. Ransack his body by your fire from the crown of his head to the soles of his feet. By faith in Jesus' name. I take God's sins by faith. I curse and detaches him from that ungodly covenant of adoption with him in the spirit. The blood of Jesus detaches him. The blood of Jesus disconnects him. The blood of Jesus destroys every covenant. Destroys every contract known or unknown to him. The blood of Jesus destroys all writings. The blood of Jesus destroys the pen and paper. The blood of Jesus disconnects him. By faith, I disconnect him from that evil spiritual altars. The blood of Jesus breaks down that evil spiritual altar. I detach them from that ungodly covenant of marriage in the spirit realm. That ungodly spirit wife, that ungodly spirit husband, spirit children, spirit family, I disconnect him by the blood of Jesus. But the blood of Jesus severs him and disconnects him by faith, even in the natural realm. Every relationship that the Father did not connect him to, by faith, I disconnect him. I disconnect him because the blood of Jesus disconnected him. The blood of Jesus detaches him from all relationship in the natural and the spirit realm that the Father did not connect him to. I disconnect in Jesus' name. Father, thank you for dispatching your angels into the spirit realm, snatching and grabbing out every spirit that's not of you out of James' mind. Out of his will, out of his emotion, out of his body, in Jesus' mighty name. James, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' mighty name, be free in your mind, be free in your mind, be free in your mind, be free in your will, be free in your emotion, be free in your dream, and be free in your heart, and be free in your body to serve the Lord thy God. Him only will you serve in spirit and truth. Be free in Jesus' mighty name. Father, fill James. Fill James with your spirit. Fill his mind. Fill his will. Fill his emotions. Fill his dream. And fill his body with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I thank you for bringing James' body back to default. Thank you, Father, for healing his mind, for healing his will, for healing his emotion, and for healing his body, Father. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Now, Father, I also pray where James lived. Holy Ghost, go search and destroy where James is at his place right now. Go in every room, Holy Spirit. Search and destroy darkness that's lurking and hiding in every room. Go in every corner, crack, and crevice of that house. Go under every bed, Holy Spirit. Burn darkness that is hiding under the bed, around the bed, over the bed, between the sheet, between the mattresses. Burn, Holy Spirit. Don't leave no area at his house untouched by your mighty fire. Burn, burn, even go in every drawer. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in Jesus' name. Go outside the house. Burn around the house, under the house, even under the ground. Burn evil objects that was planted under the house, under the ground. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn all kinds of darkness that have attached itself to his property. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, for setting your son totally free. Thank you, Father, for cleansing him. Thank you, Father, for filling him with your presence. Father, continue, Father, give him revelation and wisdom and understanding and knowledge. Empower him with your mighty spirit, Father. Thank you, Father, for placing a hedge of protection around him and all his properties, Father. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name, for he shall be a powerful witness. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name, for keeping him, Father. I thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, that every door that the enemy had closed off to him, and it's your will to be open, Father. I open those doors. And every door, Father, that you have opened that the enemy have closed, I open those doors. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Just let them feel your love, your warmth, and your compassion, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your presence. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your presence, Father. Thank you, Father, for filling him to overflow with your spirit, Father. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen, amen. Amen, Brother James, in Jesus' mighty name. You are totally free. You are
thank
free.
You, Jesus, thank you, thank God
name.
For you. Thank God
thank
for you and your family. Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Glory to your holy name. It is done. It is done. It is done.
Thank
amen,
you, Jesus.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to
thank
your
thank you,
holy
Lord.
Name. Thank you,
thank
Jesus.
You so much.
Thank
oh, Lord,
Lord.
I didn't wait
too long for this God. Thank you, Lord. Glory
please
to you.
Please bless my mother
thank
and seeing
God.
Thank you, Lord. Oh,
thank
my
you.
Lord God.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Opening
those doors that should be to be opened. The enemy has closed off to my bed, Lord. Thank you, Father, for opening those doors. Thank you for even closing the doors that was not your will. Thank you, thank you, Father, for making his way prosperous. Thank you, Father, for bringing the devil to a shame in his life. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name. We magnify you. We exalt you always, Father. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Father. Thank you so much.
Thank
you.
You are so great.
I love you, man. Thank you so much. I thank God for you.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Glory.
Thank
you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Father, for the many plans you have for this dear brother. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Glory to you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Glory to your heart. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Thank you, Father.
Yes,
Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Father.
Amen. Amen, Brother James. So, Brother James, share with us, Brother James, what you was experiencing.
Just a minute ago.
Yeah, as I was praying fire prayers, what was you experiencing?
Oh, God. Just got so hot. It got. I'm in the kitchen, sitting down at the table, with the telephone on, and I'm sitting here, and I'm sweating up a storm. I'm sweating up a storm. And and this demon started manifesting in me. And all I could remember was when Jesus cast out some demons in the Bible, they came out with a loud shout, a loud yell. And every time I heard fire, you say fire. They didn't want to hear it. These demons didn't want to hear that.
Jesus.
They didn't want to hear that. They didn't want to hear it. Oh, God, thank you so much, you know. And I'm so thankful, Evangelist. I mean, God truly chases the ones he loves. He knew I didn't mean no harm. I didn't mean no harm. I used to pray so many foolish prayers. Like when I was in Georgia, I used to pray things like this. I would say, Lord, if you give me fame, Lord, if you get, you know, I would fast 3 whole days with no food, just drinking water and juice. But I would say, Lord, if you give me fame, I would turn my life around and live for you. And the millions and millions of fans that follow me, when I turn my life around and live for you, we'd all be following you. I'd get them to serve you too. But the Lord told me this. He said, if I'd allowed you to sign one of those record contracts,
that's right,
there would have been no turning around for you. It would have been too late. He said, I would have signed my name in blood, and I would have signed my name over to Satan. There would have been no coming back for me. He truly does. He knows what's best.
He sure
and I just thank him. He is such a caring parent.
Amen.
I love him so much. Oh,
amen.
Wow, amen. Wow, wow, wow.
Amen.
I love him so much. Wow.
Amen. You are totally free.
Yeah,
you're totally
free.
How do you feel, James? How do you feel?
I can't explain it. I'm hot. I'm sweating. But I feel lightheaded. I feel kind of lightheaded. Like I'm floating on cloud nine, as they say.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like, I mean, I'm going to flush these medications as soon as I go back upstairs.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to get into some worship. I'm going to praise my God, our God. I'm going to love on him because he didn't have to do this for me.
No,
he didn't have to do this.
You need that lightheadedness. You got to realize that was a great spiritual battle. That was a great spiritual battle, and that's what that lightheadedness is. You're experiencing that great spiritual battle. So now you make sure you eat something and drink water so you can replenish your body.
Okay,
that's important because you just went through a great battle. That was a tremendous battle, James. See, I usually don't have people who stick around and listen to the program. But today, after deliverance of these two ladies, they stuck around. They didn't know why they were sticking around, but the Lord knew it was God who had them to stay on the line so they can join their faith with my faith for your total deliverance. Because more of us, when we come together, more devils are put to flight. Now, even though we didn't hear those two ladies, they was battling for you at their home. They was also battling for you. And those devils had the dirt. That's the reason why your body was sweating. That Holy Ghost fired. He was ransacking the place. You know when a thief come into your home and ransack your home, they tear up everything. I mean, they look in places that you didn't know that it was there. Well, that's what the Holy Ghost does. When I say Holy Ghost fired, ransack the body, the mind, the will, emotion, he goes in all those places. He goes in places where darkness hides and we don't even know that they was there. But the Holy Ghost blew them out by his mighty fire. And he's a consuming fire. Yeah. So that's the tremendous heat that you felt. And that's and that was evidenced by the sweat. Because even in your session, and another session I had, here I am sitting here doing session. My body ain't moving, but all of a sudden, my body sweats. tremendously, and I know that's the anointing of God upon my life to minister deliverance to his dear children. And with you, I felt that heat just like you. I felt that heat and that sweat, and that was Holy Ghost fire.
Yeah.
So you are totally set free in Jesus' name. So you obey the leading of the Holy Spirit, because you think about this. In 98, you never needed that medication. That was a trick of the enemy to get you addicted to the medication so that you would think by taking it, it comforts you. We only have one comforter, and that is the Holy Ghost. He is our comforter. So in the beginning, you never needed it. It was kind of people who did not know and understand that there was demons in you that was manifesting. So they said you needed the medication. It had nothing to do with no medication. You needed to be delivered. So you don't need to continue with it. That belongs to that. That medication belongs to the devil. Those types of medication. Now, it's a totally different thing if physically there was something wrong with your body and the doctor put you on it to correct whatever that problem is that's happening in your body. And you trust the Lord for healing you. So you still take your medication, but at the same time, you trust in the Lord that the manifestation of your healing will manifest itself in this natural realm, so that when you go to the doctor, when he diagnoses you, he'll see that physical problem is gone. But in your case, that medication don't have nothing to do with no physical problem. It's a mental psychological problem. It's a mental psychological problem. There's nothing even wrong with your brain. Again, I could see if there was something wrong with your brain, and that's the reason why you have to take that medication. But there's nothing wrong with your brain. Your problem is a spiritual problem, and no physical medicine could take care of that spiritual problem. All it needed was those demons to be cast out of you, and then when they left, all of those problems, that psychological mental problem is gone. And also, James, what I observed after your deliverance, now when I first brought you on, I heard a female voice through you. There was a female voice through you. That spirit had you sounding just like a female. Just like a female. Yeah. So I knew that homosexual spirit was also in you. But now, after your deliverance, when I ask you a question, the first thing I behold, lo, is a masculine voice. You bet.
Right.
How the Lord created you. And your voice sounds like a man now. It don't have that feminine sound to it, because Satan and all of his belongings, his properties, had to leave you. God has set you totally free. Amen. So you share. The first person you share it with is your wife. Just share. Now, I'm not telling you she's going to receive it. You know, God did not tell us people are going to receive our testimony. He told us to go and tell what great things God have done for you. So you share with her what God has done. And then you leave it up to her to say, you know what, I need deliverance. I want to be delivered. Then you can lead her to call me as you. But in the meantime, till she get delivered, remember, it's not her that's going to start reacting. It's that demon in her. So again, you always look at her, you smile at her, you treat her the way Jesus said to treat her. You love her the way Jesus said to love her. But then, you know, out of her presence, you come against that spirit and say, no, I bind you, shut up. Because sometimes they do be running their mouth, you know, and it's not your wife, it's that spirit. And you say, shut up in Jesus' name. I silence you in the name of Jesus. Hush up. And you find that all of a sudden she'll get real quiet. That's because that spirit cannot talk. So just always remember who you are battling against. It's not against your wife. It's against that spirit. And in the meantime, you just continue to trust God, that the same God who led you to your helper to be set free, you trust in God that he also, at his time and doing the work, so your wife can change and receive him, will be led to her helper. In Jesus' name.
Okay.
It is done in
Gotcha.
Jesus' mighty name. And remember, now you two are married. Make sure now, as a husband and wife, you do not bring fetishism into the marital bed. That's another way demons will enter back into you. Remember, you know,
what is that?
Fetishism. Fetishism is introducing anything into the marriage bed so that you can get aroused. You
Okay.
don't do that. Okay. You know, our mouth is not the part of our body that was made for sex. You know, no. You don't
Okay.
do that.
Okay.
That's not of
Right.
God. You be inviting demons into your bedroom. And if you do that, the spirit
Okay.
of anger will enter you. And then once anger gets into you, it's going to open the door for all those other spirits to get right back into you. So Lord said, be
Okay.
obedient in that area. It don't matter, you know, your wife said, well, I like it, you know, I enjoy it. Said, no, that's not God's way. That's not God's way. No, that won't the way that was not the reason why the mouth was created. No, that's perversion.
Right.
It's perverted. That's perversion. And God's not pleased. The foremost
Right.
person
Okay.
you the foremost person you seek to please is Jesus Christ. You love your wife.
That's right.
I love my husband. We love our spouse. But when they tell us to do things that is contrary to the law, that's where we say no. That's where the Lord said, you know, submit ourselves one to another in the Lord. Wives, obey your husband in the Lord. Same thing with the men, with the wife, in the Lord. In the Lord. When they
That's right.
tell us to do things contrary to the Lord, you say, I cannot do that. You are not my God. I love you, but you are not my God. My God is Jehovah. Him only will I serve in Jesus' name. And you continue to do that, James, you will continue to stay free and be free. Remember, you know, you can send me an email, go to my website, get the email anytime you have a question, because you may have some questions. Just feel free to email me. And as soon as I can, I will respond to your email, okay? But praise the living God. I thank God for
I thought I had, what is your email address?
It's MiteWorks, MiteWorks at the children's. Mite.org. Children have an S at the end. The children's mite. MITE.org.
Okay.
It's on the website.
Okay.
My website.
Okay.
So praise the living
okay,
God.
Okay.
You have been such a blessing, whether you realize or not, you encourage us all. Your deliverance encourage us all. Praise the living God. Amen.
It's been a blessing to me as well. And tell my other sisters, I said thank you. I thank y'all so much. God bless y'all.
They hear you. They still up here and they hear you. Praise his holy name. Amen. Amen. Okay. So you stay blessed now, okay?
Okay.
All right.
All right. And okay. Hopefully this will be the last time us talking. Hope y'all
Amen.
Will get some business.
That'll be great, James. That'll be great. All right then.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Praise the living God. Okay. Now, dear heart, I think that's it. I'm going to end the sessions for today. I'm trying to think there's somebody else up here, but I don't have enough time. My time has ran out. I think there's 1141 use up here. So do me a favor, 1141, because my next session is not until next week. But since you've been waiting for a little while, I'm giving you permission to send me an email at mikeworks@thechildrenmike.org and include your phone number, and I'll call you for a session probably sometime over the weekend, okay? That way you don't have to wait till next week since you was online for a little while. That's 1141. So that's mikeworks@thechildrenmike.org. Make sure you send me your number and make sure you say I'm the one that was on hold and you're giving me instruction to email you for a session on the weekend. Okay? So praise the living God. Thank you, Jesus. I thank God for setting captives free. He loves us so much. You know, this week has been very busy. I had a lot of calls on yesterday and today. Praise his holy name. So I thank the Lord for empowering me with his spiritual and physical strength to minister his grace and mercy to his dear children. So remember, dear heart, I come on live again on next week, Wednesday and Thursday at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. You can call 720-820-1363. In international, you go to the webpage at freeconferencecall.com/wild/evangelistking. Find your country, dial in number, and enter SS code 335950. So praise the living God. And dear heart, stay blessed in Jesus' mighty name. Shalom.